All right, today what we're going to do is show a patch panel here. Got this MG fender here where the guy wants repaired, and you can see there's a lot of lead work, and from the back side we saw there's a lot of holes back here, so we got to cut this out. A couple different ways that we can do it, but what we're going to do is probably going to come across, maybe blend down or come into here. You can see we got a compound, there's a 90 degree, another 90 degree coming back here, and then a 90 degree bend with feels like maybe 5-6 spot welds. So what you need to do this, you guys pretty much have already, MIG welder, safety, your glasses, gloves always when working with sheet metal, 4-inch grinder, and pick up some of our flap discs. These things are great, both for weld prep. You'll see how this will remove any of this surface rust in a moment. And then weld blending, real nice. They run pretty cool, so you're not warping metal. Pencil or a scribe. I like using pencils on sheet metal instead of Sharpies. Sometimes if you're using a Sharpie on there, you don't get it wiped off clean. You go ahead to start building your primers and it starts bleeding through. Tape measure, tape itself, a square. Now cutting metal, two different choices. You can hand job it with some snips here, or we make this nice electric shear, which I'll use that just to show you how it cuts. It's great. You can do scroll cutting, general radiuses, straight line. But the heart of it is our patch panel kit. And this is the kit opened up here. This is great. This pretty much gives you all the necessary, other than the ancillary here, to get the job done. Our new 6-inch seaming pliers, these things are great. These are equivalent to a small break. Self-drilling screws here. These are used when you want to do any type of patches in a floor. You go ahead, drill your patch panel, drill some holes around here, form it to what you want, and then run your sheet metal screws in there. Pulls up the old floor onto the new metal. You can go ahead and do your perimeter weld, pull out the screws, then just do plug welds. Double-ended 316 drill bits here. What these are used for is for doing the plug weld holes, and we'll show you that. So let's go ahead and get started. First thing you can see, got this up on our fender stand. And if you're just doing a little bit of body work and sanding on a fender, it's fine, you can lay it over. But if you're ever going to do any, like we're going to do, a lot of work, here's a little trick right there. Just tack it to the stand. You come across with your cutoff wheel and zip it off. But what it does is a lot more sturdier than chasing this thing all over the horse itself. So, last part, the metal itself. What this is our aluminized steel. This is the same aluminized material that a lot of the large exhaust manufacturers are using for corrosion resistance. And that's what we offer. That way when you go ahead, you're putting a patch panel in here, your backside, we're going to tell you to go ahead and prime it, but you got the peace of mind that you're not going to have any corrosion starting. Got a bunch of these 1-inch wide strips. I'll show you some tricks here. These are going to be used for what are called backers to go ahead and get your patch panels coming. A couple 12 by 12s and then a 12 by 24. So you can see, you can do some large patches with this. Cut it out, you can do a lot of small holes. One of these kits will get you pretty much, depending on the severity of the corrosion that you have on the vehicle, it could do everything that you have on there for a fraction of the price of a replacement panel. So we're going to go ahead and get started here. What I'm going to do is find an area. What we're going to do here, either come across or that market, go ahead and flap disc. And then on this side here, we'll get the corrosion off of here, start drilling out the spot welds. Alright, we got the spot welds drilled out. You can see where down there the metal's really weak. So what we're going to do with our patch panel is just come around there, reinforce that area. So you can come in here and now just slowly pull the metal top piece here right off of your base structure. Got a ground down here on this side where the spot welds were coming across here. One of the things you want to do is never have this sharp 90 degree corner here. Just take a file and break that corner. Just never end up with a sharp corner on any kind of sheet metal work. Trusty manila folder. Can't go wrong with here. We're just going to get quick rough size. We know we need about a 3/4 inch overhang there. We're going to need a 90 on the bottom. So easiest, quickest way to get lines on this is just take your drill bit. You get a real good idea of your rough opening. See, we're going to come around, come down here, capture this same overhang. But then right here, what we did was we just brought it out. Let's go to the area where we're missing metal here. Patch that corner up. And then it comes across, fills. And then under here, same thing. We're going to keep this 90 degree flange running all the way back. So what you can see is this is what you're trying to do, a butt weld here. Tacking that on there, and as long as your template or your pattern is cut exactly to the dimensions of your opening, that'll work out. But if for any reason you have to do an adjustment where you end up with a gap, you have a problem. Now you're either cutting new metal or you're trying to fill it. And what you don't want to do is try bridging that gap with your MIG weld, because of it, you know, the weld deposit's going to be more brittle than the surrounding area. That's where you're going to get your cracks. You'll see the hairline in your primer levels. All right, so what we'll do to eliminate any of the fitment here, so we're going to use doublers. And that's what these strips are for. They're included with the kit. And this can be done for a small, you know, 8.5 inch patch like we're doing here, or the full run of a quarter panel. The process is done the same. What we're going to do is we're going to cut these to length. They're going to fit behind here as a doubler. Now you can see they're about 1 inch wide. So what we're going to do is put 1/2 inch up here. We're going to drill some 316 plug weld holes. So now we clamp it, plug weld it. Now that's your doubler, your backing plate. So now when your patch panel goes in there, if you have any little misfits right in there where just alignment doesn't work out, you go ahead and now you're welding to the backup plate and to the main piece here. Great for strength and also just to take up, like I said, any of the little issues. Now with this being aluminized on here, we're not going to have to worry about any type of corrosion in the seam there. But what we will do is we'll spray it with some of our weld through primers just to give a little bit more insurance. Same thing with the back of this panel. First, what we want to do though, pick a size that's close to your template here and unfold your template. Mark your bends. And again, all we're doing is following the manila folder template. Go ahead, use your seaming pliers. These things are great. Nice 6-inch length, covers a lot of your panel. Just get on your bend line. Get on a nice flat surface. Just get your 90 degree break going. Now what I'm going to do is rather than bend just a corner of it up, since this is longer, slowly work it. That way you have a very uniform bend. What we'll do is we'll just keep working that up. Do this bend, fold it over. In a couple minutes here, we'll have a patch. Just going to drill a couple holes here. Recreate the spot welds. Just do this with a 316 bit. A little trick with sheet metal, you're always going to end up with that burr on there. Rotary deburring tool is the best thing. If you don't have it, just a quick one is drill bit, about 3 sizes up from what you're using. That'll clean it up real nice. Behind here, we're going to plug weld them. So what I want to do is mark, same thing, about 1 inch apart. And when you're drilling these, another trick, if you can, hold your bend. Rather than try and drill like this through the edge of metal, you're going to end up pushing and warping. Give yourself a backer block. Go ahead and cut your backer. Same thing. Don't like sharp corners. It's a lot easier to weld. Angled corner. Much safer on the skin. You can clamp this. You got any type of vice grips, welding clamps, whatever you want to do. I'm going to show you a prototype here of our new spot weld plier. This guy is great. Alright, now we just got done with the top ones here. You can see they look almost like factory spot welds, but actually plug welds. So what we want to do is same thing. Take our backer. And the same thing, we're just going to move on up the line until we get them all tacked in. And these are easy to grind there. Flap this takes them right off. What it does is now it gives you... See, here's a butt weld where you'd want to be right up in there. Now we cut this. We got pretty lucky on the cut. It worked out pretty good. But if you're a little off or you got a fit, you now can weld to your backer, weld your original metal to the backer, and then fill it. Go ahead and blend it, and you got a nice... sort of concave weld, which is perfect to begin if you do need a skim coat or if you want to just come over with your filler surfacers. But we just line up our patch. It's going to work out real nice down here. You can see that. Those two are going to clamp right in place right there. Come up along this side. So we're just going to go ahead and just tack a corner here. Everything welded in here, spots come across here, it's tacked. So what we're going to do is going to just start working. Work here a little, here, keep moving around, filling it in. What we're going to do is show you how to just do quick stitch welding. What you're going to do is just do bursts. Just holding it for, you know, just a moment, less than a second. Do four or five together, then move to another area and come back. That's it. Now what you do, you come, move somewhere else, get a couple more in, and keep moving around the panel. Now you can see with just a couple minutes of grinding, just a few quick hits with a 60 grit flap disc, how quickly it levels that bead right off of there, then we'll be able to come back, smooth it, blend it real nice into the rest of the panel. Backside here. We'll prime or we can leave it as is, but you can see where we have solid parchment here with the welds through there, and then the patch panel piece into our backer tied into the original piece of steel.